居家紧急救护地点民东两段92巷口出动意外，麻请意外逃人出勤。
As soon as the alerting system goes off, firemen rush to put on their personal protective equipment and hurry to their next mission. And from the looks of it, it is COVID-19 related.
从疫情大爆发4月底到现在，其实我们平均一天的量能大概是18到20件。像5月1号到今天5月10号，已经有170件了。早期去年的疫情是我们由防疫专队先优先跑。那现在是所有的台北市的消防局救护车，目前线上是65部，全部都是一起上线在跑。想跟民众呼吁，就是说，如果他已经打电话叫救护车，希望他把他自身的一些证件、还有他的钱，还有一些随身携带贵重物品先带着，不要我们在现场又要等他准备这些东西打包，这是节省我们彼此的时间。
With the biggest outbreak of the pandemic yet in the country, according to reports from the Ministry of Interior, the fire department has had an increase of at least 1.2 times the mission.
那我们平常这边是有8台车的，那今天现在只剩下1台车，
支援疫情就对了。
对，然后像我们现在疫情需求量会越来越大，会越来越多这样子。
因应疫情的关系呢，救护车也有升级。我们进到里头呢，看到这一块隔板，它呢是在新型的车款才有出的。这隔板呢特别隔开了驾驶舱还有救护舱，就是呢为了隔绝病毒的传播。另外还有看到这个呢是紫外线灯，熄火的时候呢也可以在这个时候进行全车的消毒。
After every mission, the first step for the firemen is to disinfect their whole body and the entire vehicle. Every single corner cannot be missed. On top of the pandemic, rainy season is upon us, which means Taiwan has officially entered a flood control period, and the firefighting capacity is bound to get even tighter. The Ministry of Interior has announced that it will start allocating more ambulance vehicles, even those used for the National Army, in order to take into account the increase in need.In addition, the public is also trying to chip in. More than 50 businesses have provided close to 400 ambulance vehicles to assist in emergency missions during a time of need.
当然是希望尽自己的一份力量啊，能够帮助这个疫情赶快的得到良好的控制。基本上是跟医疗院所、医疗单位做合作，然后那因为这一次疫情的关系，我们也接受 CDC。的指挥也接受卫生局的派遣，大概会增加30%的勤务量。民众也好，机构或者单位也好，希望能够很诚实的，跟我们陈述这个病人他的状况，不要让救护人员成为传播的媒介。
As cases continue to be on the rise, our emergency responders are all working hard on the job to keep the Taiwanese citizens as safe as possible.However, as the country has not yet entered the peak period when it comes to the pandemic, it is important to take this time to deploy a comprehensive plan in advance before an even larger outbreak that might be coming our way. TVBS English News.